How do you protect your Facebook account? How do you make your Facebook profile more secure? Recently, I have heard some cases where their Facebook profile got hacked, and this is some ways that you can use to help to secure your Facebook profile, and that is by using two-factor authentication. Hi, before I show you how to do it, my name is Ken and I talk a lot about digital marketing and entrepreneurship. And if you like these kind of topics, do subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification bell, help this channel grow so that I can keep producing valuable content like this to share with all of you. And with that, let me just first tell you why again it's important to switch on two-factor authentication. One thing is that when people log in using a device that's unknown, which is by another phone or by another PC or even through incognito mode, right? You want to make sure that when people log in, you receive a notification that somebody should log in. And after that, you will use the two-factor notification to allow that login. This happened because I know some people, when they create their profile, they do not want the hassle of having two-factor notification. And because of that, there are some people that actually got hacked and the whole profile got changed and things like that, but you cannot recover it because the two-factor notification is not on. So it's very good to have it on. The second thing is that, especially when you're a Facebook advertiser, you need it to be on. If not, you might have some issues, or you might have your ad account got disabled and things like that. So this is one way to make sure that your account is stable and your account does not receive any problems when you're running Facebook ads. So it is very important for you to turn on the two-factor notification, especially if you are a Facebook advertiser. I think recently, 1-2 months ago, if you do not turn it on, you're not allowed to advertise, especially in Business Manager. So you need to turn it on. So this is important for you to do it, right? Okay, now without further ado, let me just go to my computer. Again, I'll show two ways you can do it. One is using computer, another one using mobile. But I'll show the computer first, then later on, I'll go into my mobile. Hi, welcome to my PC, and now let me show you how you can do it with your computer, right? So you obviously need to log into your Facebook account. Then next, you click on this arrow, this account. So this is the dark version layout and also the new layout for Facebook. I'm sure most people already changed into this kind of layout, right? So anyway, you click on here, the top right, go to accounts, go to settings and privacy, and go to settings. Next, you go to security and login. Next, you go to use two-factor authentication. As you can see, mine is switched on. So you require me to re-enter password. So after you put in your password, you'll be coming into this two-factor authentication page. Right, as you can see, it's turned on. I do not advise to turn off, as mentioned earlier. It's good for your safety of your account, and also it's good especially when you're advertising in Facebook. So you switch it on. So there's a few methods here, which is the mobile authenticator app, security key, recovery code, right? So I will usually use you can use one only. I use two because I was testing out the authenticator app. So when you put it here, right, when you put your phone number here, what you will do is they will send you an SMS with code, and that's the reason why you can use different phone number or turn off. So if you have, for example, change your phone number, please, when you're using Facebook, do not forget to change your phone number here or change to different authenticator app. You can even add new authenticator app here. As in the security key, you can add a new one, a new authenticator app and things like that, right? So just make sure you have everything just in case, right? The other thing that's different in mobile and here, let me just state out earlier on first, is that the recovery codes, there are codes that you can use in case you lost your phone, right? So the security key as well. This one, I'm not very sure what is it. I have not used it personally myself. So I think you will need a USB or NFC card available when you want to use this. So it's like when you use bank, you have this card sometimes where you can key in the PIN. So I guess this is a security key. The security key is a manual thing that you hold. You can use it as well. I'm not setting this up because I don't have a USB that's available. But you might test this as well, because I heard a lot of stories that people lost their phone, changed their phone, they didn't do anything. But just remember, before you change phone, change number, make sure you change all this, make sure it's available, because Facebook, especially now where Facebook is being scrutinized for their privacy policies, for their privacy issues. So it's better to have all this available. Make sure to change all this when you want to change itself, right? And now let me jump into the mobile site so you can have a look. And yeah, let's go to the mobile. First of all, you open up your Facebook app in your mobile, right? Then you click on the top right, which is the three lines icon. This is what you call as burger icon. Then you go to settings. After that, you go to security and login. Then you go to use two-factor authentication, right? Click on it. Then you can turn on and off is on here. I have turned it on because it's important for my account to be safe, right? So there's two security methods that I do, which one is SMS, another one is authentication app. So the authentication app that I use is a Google authentication app. So for you can use any other. You see, there's another backup method. So in the backup method, you can add another authentication app. I think there's other authentication app other than Google Authentication. And next, you can do recovery codes as well. So when you click on the recovery codes, later I'll show you. Okay, when you click on recovery codes, okay, this advanced, let me just go through the advanced first. So the advanced is when there's any notification they will message you. I think this is not needed because you'll be charged accordingly for the SMS. Right, now let's go to the recovery code. Right, so when you use recovery codes, there are the codes they will give to you, right? I think there's 10 codes here. Yeah, there's 10 codes here. So you copy the codes and save the code somewhere else, which is on your phone. So this, you can use this code when you have no access to your mobile, when you cannot receive SMS, or you cannot access to your Google Authentication or any other authentication app that you're using. So you can use this code to get it. But these codes can only be used once. After that, the code will be gone. But for now, I'm not needing this, but this could be good in case you are very worried that you get locked out, right? That's it for phone. Thank you. Yep, that's it. That's just a simple method that you can use to turn on the two-factor notifications and some other options that you can use for the two-factor notifications. And with that, I hope this is useful for you. And if you like what I've shared, do consider subscribing to my channel. Turn on the notification bell so that I keep receiving content like this, and so that I can help more people, you know, help this little channel grow as well, so that I can reach more people. And with that, thank you very much for watching. Feel free to hit me up on social media or put anything in the comment section if you have any questions. And with that, I'll see you in my next video. Subscribe and goodbye.